Let's go. Wait, I can use a ball. Thank you. Come on, give me something good.
Yes!
That's exactly what I need. Alright, let's go, let's go! Let's get this going. I got some coinage to make today. This team got 84 today, at least an 83. No, not bad, not bad. Only the 32, that looked a lot better than the 32. Please be a Jai. Good. I like your Riddick, but I need somebody to blow it up in the middle right now. Damn, Ajayi. I went from the 32 to the 34.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there.
I like that I finally got a freaking one lineman over 80.
Creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
This is caught by Antonio Brown. And he slips up past
the 45. Let's go. Let's go. Let's
pick up a 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Alright,
that's the first glimpse of Antonio Brown in this game, and he's a guy that's a threat each and every time the ball heads in his direction. Coming off the second year where he led the league in receiving yards.
And he can't get rid of it.
Damn, I went down. Screw you, Casey. Alright, Ertz, let's get you open. I mean, well, I guess it's not Ertz.
Especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You talk about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
That time they hit him out of the slot on the drag.
And that route takes some fortitude from the guy running it because he knows he's going through the briar patch, as I like to call it, right? He's trying to work his way through all that traffic, and people want to put a little contact on it. Really well done.
First catch for him on the afternoon, and it results in a first down.
That throw's not going to get him a whole lot, but that really didn't matter, did it? They got what they needed on that throw. Picked up the first down, and I'm going cliche here. Game of inches, partner.
Absolutely. And you talked to me a lot about opening drives, how key those are to set the tone. You kept the drive alive. Third down conversion here is big. Give him 30 yards there. How about the start throwing the football? 4 for 4 on this opening drive.
Oh, he's slinging it. And oftentimes when you talk about slinging it, you're thinking about a guy throwing it all over the yard. Not necessarily.
Damn.
Accurately. In this case, though, he's honing in on his targets, and he's delivering.
Yeah, the opening script, however they drew it up for this first drive, going to plan so far.
And Brandon, as we continue to see, so much of the influence on this game is now coming from those hybrid-type players. In this case, strong safety, not worried about covering the pass.
Oh my God, Urch, just stand there, you idiot.
The pre-game introductions, he introduced himself with authority on that play.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
He can run for it, and he will. Give him 8 yards that time on the scramble, and now fourth down.
Well, partner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to escape out of there, and he doesn't pick up a first down.
Back alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. This long drive continues here to start the second quarter. They are, however, facing a fourth down situation. So still no touchdown.
I'm not going to destroy my momentum.
Some action on the scoreboard with the field goal.
So maybe now the mentality changes in this game because anytime you get to the red zone and if you don't come away with 6 points, you feel like it's a disappointment. In a game like this,
oh, hell no.
Field goals means you're
Elliot, what are you doing on kickoffs?
To take you over the top.
Ball up to the 35 now.
What? What are you doing on the other side? At linebacker? Is that Vita Villa? What the hell? I'm confused at why my defense is this. Alright, now we're back to a defense that makes sense. What the hell was that ghetto? Get this, Sean Watson. You already lost. Ain't no chance, ain't no stopping me. Let's go secondary, you're all over 83, damn near.
Third and long, it's Watson, and that is incomplete.
Well, no second guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart
thing.
And now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves gaining some momentum.
Oh man, I did not expect that actually. I'm not gonna lie.
58 to go in this first half of play.
Alright.
Back to Tennessee after this.
All right, at Ertz, because I don't think Adams is going to get over him.
Coach will have highlights and analysis of this first half, one that's featured no touchdowns as of yet on either side.
So his job's a little bit easier for this halftime.
Maybe get the coach some highlights here.
Yes, we do.
A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
They really love to get him into one-on-one opportunities, and this is one way. Work him out of the slot and create a mismatch. Who's going to cover him? Corner, safety, linebacker? He's got a way to beat all of those positions.
The left side throw complete to Adams. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. They got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. First down, Rodgers. Flushed out right. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Seems like this defense, especially the secondary, has really been contesting about every throw in this first half.
Remind me of a good half-court defensive basketball team. Every time a pass is thrown, they're right there in a good defensive position, able to affect the play.
Riddick light on his feet. And he's got this one across midfield into Cowboy territory. Well, they get six here after the incompletion.
That's Dix right there. That's ha-ha.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
It's caught here by Adams. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. As they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Could we get a touchdown in this first half after all? It's first and 10. Rodgers now on first down. Ertz has it left side. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. 15 yards there on the catch and run.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide it. With a tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6. On play action, it's Rodgers.
Oh, shit.
They can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. As the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime. Third and long, it's Rodgers. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go.
Well, he'd been targeted quite a bit on this drive, and finally I think the guys on the defensive side, they said no more. They saw the double coverage on him, made it very tough for him to get the ball.
And his kick is good. Didn't hit it all that well, but he got enough on it to put it through. And that will double their lead as it's up to 6. Still a little bit of time.
Let's go.
Mop
patrol. Mop patrol. Mop patrol. Oh, it's Dallas Cowboys in Tennessee.
9 seconds to play. Likely the final snap of the first half as it's first and 10. They start on the ground with Elliott. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 34-yard line. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. The final shot before the break.
No!
And this one is incomplete. That's it. Due to time constraints, we move you forward in today's broadcast to the beginning of the third quarter. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This one fielded at the 5. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. come the Cowboys now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this of intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. And so we're moving over. And some nifty running there. Ultimately, it doesn't get him a whole lot, but it does take him to the 45. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
On second down, Elliott. It's a pickup of 6.
Damn it, man, they're ruining me. Not good.
He does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
Now a play fake here on first down. A battle for it, and it's intercepted. It's the 2014 NFL interception leader, Glover Quinn.
Well, they didn't exactly show patience there, did they? Just down the score, they come out firing right away and compound things by throwing an interception. They put their defense in a really tough spot.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to be taken down shy of the 10, right around the 9-yard line. Ray Lewis up from his linebacker spot to make the play.
That was Ray. What? I didn't know that was Ray.
Ravens of all time. Ray Lewis's name comes up pretty fast, doesn't it? Tackles like that, just the tip of the iceberg when he's trying to talk about his talent.
Bottled up, fumble. It's out. It's loose.
And
they're already knocking on the door inside the 4-yard line.
They may have the edge on the scoreboard, but that hasn't made them passive, has it?
I mean, they've got a
pretty good run blitz there, and Brandon, you know,
that isn't the problem.
Our blitzes aren't just designed to get to the quarterback in the passer. Sometimes he's trying to take away every gap.
There's two boxes. One's in one of the containers. Yep.
And we see yet another errant throw as a result. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up 3rd. Trying to get their tight end involved finally. That's the first time that they've looked his way. He's kind of been a forgotten man in this offensive scheme.
Yeah, did look his way all in the first half. And I'll bet you the offense coordinator made a note at the half and said, let's get him involved. Because
and he's going to go down, sacked back at the 13-yard line.
And that's the kind of stand all defenses are seeking. 3rd and goal, backs against the wall, and they get a monster sack. And now they're going to force him into a field goal. For them, that's a win.
And Lando will put this one through. And they are on the board, trailing now 6-3. The bottom line, tremendous starting field position, really squandered there as they wind up going backwards and then come up with just 3.
Well, getting the 3 turned out to be important. I can imagine the head coach when he ordered the field goal. Please salvage something out of this drive. That was not fun to watch.
Back onto the field comes the offense for the Madden Legends. And last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive. Now Rodgers throwing on 2nd down. What can't Aaron Rodgers do? The legwork there, getting into 1st.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. Now that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. It's a loss of a yard there, and now 2nd down. The 4th quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. Now Rodgers. He gets it to Brown. Complete. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. So it's our visitors with the football as we get you reset. They've got a 1st and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. Here's a guy looking for a seam but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. Another running situation on the doorstep as they come up 2nd and 10. Rodgers looking to throw, and the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
We've seen good cover skills on display throughout this game, really from both teams, and there's another nice example there of them making it difficult to complete a pass.
Big play coming up. Here's 3rd and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. Hurts over the middle. He'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. And now the Cowboys are going to call another timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And Quigley now on to punt as he sends this one away. And a nice job here on special teams. This will be down inside the 10 at the 8-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point
kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him in contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him in contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Bash, dude.
Super toe.
To throw. He's going to let it fly. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Trevor Williams with a pick. And the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line.
And that one, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the 2-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to go up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw, and it'll wind up being intercepted.
They run with a Johnny. Oh, no, he lost the football. And this is going to get out of bounds, so they will gain a bit of yardage on the play, actually, and they'll hold on to their football as well.
And I have to admit, partner, that I've often thought that I don't like this rule, where the offensive player fumbles the ball and goes out of bounds, and they get to keep it.
That's just because you're a defensive guy. That's why you don't like it.
Yeah, you're right. It is a slanted view, isn't it?
But that's he's taken down. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. As they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Now Rodgers. Sliding out of the pocket. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. Give him 9 on the play, and it'll be 4th down. And this is good. He got just enough to clear the crossbar as he drops it in from long distance. And they continue to lead in the battle of field goals here. It's now 9-3. So they get to 3, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question, because when I look at the smiles on that side of the field, they're a little tight, aren't they? If they had scored a touchdown there, those would be big half-moon grins right now because they feel a whole lot better about their position.
And a touchdown in the other direction, all of a sudden they're down. They'll start the drive with Elliott, and he stopped immediately there. The Pro Bowl end to Marcus Ware there to take him down. The Cowboys looking to get going again in a hurry. And with the clock ticking under 2.
Is the coach in Orlando, and you're tuned in to Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Straight ahead, we've got a good one in store between the Madden Legends and the Philadelphia Eagles. With that, let's get up to the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. We're standing by for the call. Our Brandon Godden.
Seems like we were just starting training camp, but here we are in October, and off we go on EA Sports. Cole now on the return.
Here's
Walsh now to kick this one off. This will be fielded at the 8. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10.
He's got a full bowl of food. He needs to calm his butt down.
That'll drive the team towards a victory.
The completion good for 3 and it's 2nd down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch.
I know. Full bowl. He's like, is there wet stuff in the bottom?
Now it's Rodgers. Steps away to his left. Give him 7 on the tuck and run, and it'll get him a new set of downs.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his
eyes. Give me a can, or I will cut you. Give me. I'm being nice. That means give me.
Shotgun now for Rodgers. And this results in 6 touchdowns.
I'm being nice. I don't do this for free, you know.
I don't have any, baby.
Well, go get some.
That was not a designed run. It was supposed to be a pass, but it
turned into a no, you definitely don't want that.
You don't have any.
He has like one little thing. It's at the in the bottom cup here. That's it. One little thing.
One
little net.
That what you want?
Just put it in there. He'll eat the whole fucking bowl and die. His grandmother did.
His grandma.
Mom.
Let's field it a few yards into the end zone. And no room back here. This will be a touchback and comes out to the 25-yard line.
Okay, we're not doing that coverage this time.
And last time the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long.
Yeah, it ain't gonna be no one play drive this time.
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up. Whether it's on your grease board, whether your playbook, one play drives exactly what you want on offense. What you have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was fairly easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
Yeah, we'll see if it's that easy here. Before the game, they were running the route tree about as efficiently and effectively as we could have possibly imagined. But sometimes the passes just go. And the pressure gets to him and brings him down. Stafford is sacked.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
3rd and long, it's Stafford. And this is going to be incomplete.
So it looked like maybe his 3rd or 4th read on his progression. Just trying to find his outlet man that time. Ends up leading him just a bit too much.
The punter wing is on as he sends this one away. Now Brown. A good return there. They take over with a 1st and 10 on the short side of the field. Out now become the legends. The last possession, these guys were able to tie the game with a touchdown. Now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense who got the ball back. The special teams went out there, handled things. They've got it. They've got momentum. I know they're eager to get out there and put it on display.
A really good pickup of 28 yards. With Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon, it's our visiting side with a football to begin quarter number two. And they've got it here with a first down. Now the Notre Dame man, this is Theo Riddick. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. 18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
They'll try to run with a Jay. And he will score. It's a touchdown. Jay and Jay taking it in from a yard out. And the Madden legends are in for six.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
Keelan Cole now to return. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
Is that Lance Kendricks? Really? No wonder you ain't got an 80 overall.
What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. To throw on second down to Stanford. And that one got tipped. Kind of threw everything off. It brings up third. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. Throwing on third down, Stanford. And that is incomplete. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. The stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
Good blocking there. Nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Madden Legends offense trotting out again. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
And he's got this down to the 35. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards. It moves the sticks.
We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved, call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch, first target.
And that's one of the reasons why.
And it is true. You can draft the fastest. You can draft the most athletic guys. But if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, that forced the incompletion.
Had his hands on it for a second. A little bit of tough catch, though. Falls incomplete. Oh, he's able to out-muscle him here as he pulls it in. And put it on the board. It's six, a touchdown. Devontae Adams, 35 yards. And the Madden Legends will extend their lead.
As a fan, is there anything prettier than a well-executed post-grab?
No, it's a thing of beauty, especially when it's done like that for a touchdown.
The throw, the catch, and how about the run after to get it to the end zone?
Santos out now. He'll kick it away. Cole now on the return. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last time where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just caught it. All right? So you got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But there got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Second and 10, Stafford again. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because any completions on first and second down, now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
Here's a carry for a former starter. This is Lamar Miller. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Now here's a whistle and a timeout. It's called by the receiving team here as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. With it is Brown. Nice job on the return there, 16 yards. The Madden legends heading back onto the field. They've really distanced themselves. They have put the pedal to the metal, I guess, so to speak.
So definitely have them in the rearview mirror, don't they? I mean, you're exactly right. Being able to string together these drives that end up in points, it's almost like a run in basketball to create that distance, and they're on a really big-time one right now.
It becomes contagious, doesn't it?
It absolutely does because oftentimes it translates to your defense as well because they're excited about getting the ball back for their offense that's playing so well.
Well, they are clicking right now. Caught on the right side by Adams. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because they'll have all...
And it's a touchdown! Devontae Adams with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Madden legends will extend their lead. Santos with the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Santos out now. He'll kick it away. Cole now on the return. Offense now gets set to head back onto the field. And right now these guys, they're shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting because three straight drives have ended with him punting the football away.
Yeah, so you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler rather than more complex in order to try and fashion together a drive.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. So, all right, hang on. We'll jump over halftime. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This one taken just inside the 10. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. Back onto the field comes the offense for the Madden Legends. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys. But be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Now it's a giant. And an alley to run. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. Good work to pick up 7 yards there. That gets him into a 3rd-and-1 situation.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. This is Ajayi. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a 4th down.
That was a terrific job by the defense, stopping them on 3rd and short. But sometimes you get some visual cues from the offense, because when they're going in short yard situations, you might see the offensive line come in tighter together, a little more shoulder to shoulder, trying to wedge a hole in the middle. They didn't get it done on that play.
Rodgers, and I'm not sure he got there. Did they stop him? They did. That's one of those in-between spots where you like to rely on analytics. Did you like the decision to go for it?
Frankly, I did, because you know I'm an aggressive guy. But that the analytics and the old school go by your feel, that's got to marry up a little bit better, because that one felt like an analytics call that someone didn't have confidence in. You know, normally this coach, I think he would have punted the ball.
Yeah, calculated risk. It didn't work out. On 2nd down, here's Miller. No gain that time, and it leaves him with 3rd and 11 coming up.
No gain on that run, and while this team is down, they're not out of it by any stretch of the imagination. Maybe you just have to think about different style of running in order to get this guy going.
Throwing is Stafford. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. It'll be a 2-yard gain, and that's going to make it 4th down.
Martin, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. Out now come the legends. And this offense, last time, turned it over, went for it on 4th, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They have their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good, but when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
Here's Reddick. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That good for 19 and a 1st down.
The reason that counter and misdirection plays work so well is that usually you've given them a reason to think that everything's going to the direction it starts initially. You've run that type of a play throughout the game. You've given them that look, and now you're going to counter things.
And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number 4. And on the ground they go with a running back. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. Only 3 there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
2nd and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a 1st down. Keep the sticks moving.
And he picks up about 6 as he gets this down to the 41.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
Now they try the right side here. Trying to turn the corner, but he's going to be stopped right near the line of scrimmage. And defensive back Jamal Adams in on the stop. Rodgers going to try and throw on 3rd down. Time for a break. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. So it's our visitors with a football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. On 4th down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this, and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And a coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build.
Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of. Otherwise, he's going to get sacked.
On third down, Stafford. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth.
Sometimes it's just not your day. There's another failure right there on third down.
Here's Brad Wing now, as he's on for the fifth time here today. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. Fielded at the 43. A great return there. Bobbing and weaving his way for 31 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The Madden Legends offense trotting out again. They take over with great field position. They've got the big lead. Most would say they should kneel it, but the key word there is should. You never know here.
You never know. That's the exact play that should happen. But some people like stats. You know, some people like to put more things up on the board. But kneel down is usually the right play here.
We'll see what they do in this situation. They run again with a Jay. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive. And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Now a handoff looking right. And he takes it inside the 10 to the 8 before he's out of bounds. Still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Give him a gain of 4, able to convert, and that sets up first and goal now. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage, back at the 6. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Rodgers throwing here. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down. They need to reverse the trend. The last 2 plays have gone backwards. Now it's 3rd and goal. Now Rodgers on the bootleg. Eluding the pressure right. This will be caught at about the 6. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing.
Charles Davis with you from our broadcast perch. And Charles, as we get this thing started, what are you going to be keeping your eye on?
Special teams. Field position is always a big determiner in a ball game. Who sets their offense up for success the best, that team will win the game.
That's fielded in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. So here are the Cowboys now ready to go on offense for the first time. And they will be led out by the four-time Pro Bowler and 2010 Comeback Player of the Year, and that's Michael Vick.
One of the most unique players in NFL history. You remember the snappy left-handed throw? The ability to break a play wide open with his legs. Absolutely dynamic, explosive, and rarely ever caught from behind. Alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
This is Melvin Gordon, and he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
Another scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker, and what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. Well, that'll get him the first down as they get 9 yards out of that quick slam.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
They go play action here on first down. Trying to lay one up deep. A 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Oh, you fucking assholes got me caught at the 1 yard line. Shit. Thanks a lot, Ramsey.
Some breathing room. They got it right there. A gain of 14 and a first down.
Partner, I think that play echoed a short yardage run. I know they're backed against their own goal line, but when they stack the defensive line like that, if you find any type of a crease, you're up to the third level before you know it.
7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a second and three.
Thanks to receivers, they'll spread the defense out, and they were able to come through with a slashing run.
But to that point, it's going to be interesting to see the personnel chess match as this one progresses.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Can they continue to create running lanes out of passing sets? And if so, it's going to be a long day for the defense.
They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue. A couple of nice carries back-to-back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these aren't bare-bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yards you're looking for, right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? Five or more yards each time. That's what you're looking for in setting the tone and getting your offensive line going.
Good sign on the opening drive. A gain of 39 that time.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And a 5-yard gain as he's down inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. So not much to speak of scoring-wise in this first quarter of play. Nothing-nothing our score.
We're back God to damn it.
For Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports.
The NFL on EA Sports is presented by Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Back with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and our drive continues here to start quarter number 2. They've got a second down at 5 here to start things out. Rodgers. The left side throw complete to Adams. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. What a methodical drive.
Damn.
This is turning out to be that time 9 yards and the sticks move again.
When you see zone defense and you know you got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Now they try the right side here. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
That didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to push his way down to about the 12. A nice job there as he rumbles for 9. And it'll be back to a 3rd and 3. The 8th play of the drive coming up. It's 3rd and 3. 2 minutes remain in a scoreless first half. We're back to Lambeau following these words. From the gun on 3rd down, Rodgers. And he connects with Ertz. And he gets the first down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the 6. It's a gain of 6 as they're able to convert, and now it's 1st and goal. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And now do you continue the drive?
And he will have a touchdown. Zach Ertz from 6 yards away. And the Madden legends are in for 6.
The big fellow was the recipient there for that touchdown pass, and it seems like more and more the tight end is the guy you have to worry about most in the passing game.
Cairo Santos on to try the extra point. Santos able to tack on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. A 10-play drive that time, and it ends with an Oakland touchdown. Santos out now. He'll kick it away. This will be fielded at the 8. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Cowboys offense heading back out and ready to go again. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the 2nd quarter, a lot of time to change things. A gain of 39 that time.
Coaches really don't care from what position they get this. But run after the catch ability, rack ability, is often the difference between winning and losing and changing field position.
On 1st and 10, here's Vic. Buying time to his left. Powerful running. Finding room to the 20. And he's all the way down to the 13-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. As they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half.
Wait, 20.
From the red zone now, Vic. This is caught. And he's brought down. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. There's Vic. And that is caught by the back judge right there to say incomplete. Antonio Brown, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down.
It's never a bad idea to try and get it to Antonio Brown, but it must be a little bit of the Madden curse going off our cover athlete here. Hasn't been able to get that elite separation that we're used to seeing from him.
They'll give it to him up the middle. And this time he's going backwards. So after the no gain on the last attempt, here they get him behind the line.
Well, there we see one reason why Bruce Smith was a first ballot Hall of Famer. As disruptive a defensive force as there ever was, 200 career sacks. Two more than my college teammate, Reggie White.
He was the number one overall pick, Bruce Smith, back in 85. And part of him. And he will score. Touchdown, Cowboys. Michael Vick taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Cowboys are an extra point away from tying the football game. And a little time left on the clock, so on the other side, they're thinking, gosh, we'd like to get that lead right back.
Yeah, thanks for pointing that out. Here I am, go ahead and tapping out the first half. There's still time. They've got to make a decision about what they want to do on the kickoff, whether they want to let their return guy touch it.
This will be fielded at the 8. And now running right through it. And a good effort on a return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. 15 seconds, all that remains for this first half as they come up first and 10. On first down, Rodgers. And he will go down, a Cowboys sack. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get him with 10 seconds to go before halftime. Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Shotgun now for Rodgers. Oh, he got position on him and he pulls it in. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. Rodgers will bring him up to the line first and 10. And he's a perfect 5 for 5 here to begin the game. A final shot before half for Rodgers. He'll rifle this one deep right side. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. And okay, so much for our halftime break. Apparently we're going to get right back to it. So thanks to the late touchdown, it's a tie ball game here heading to break. This one taken just inside the 10. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. The Madden legends heading back onto the field. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
Rodgers to throw on second down. It's caught here by Adams. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Play action. Now it's Rodgers. And Adams has it complete. And he finally goes down, but not before reaching the 21. A big play there, Rodgers to Adams. And even 40 yards.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available, but put the ball in the receiver before any defender can step up and fail.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. No gain on the play there. Second down. Flag comes in. This might be a free play. And they drop him for a loss, but penalty markers are on the field. Let's see about the call.
Offside. Defense.
And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Rodgers from the gun on third down, dancing to his left. He may try and run for this, and this will be a touchdown. Aaron Rodgers, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Madden legends are in for six. Well, the defensive coverage was good, so good, he just decided to make a play of his own, and it worked out.
Yeah, you often wonder if they think to themselves, was the coverage too good to allow him to run the football? I think you'd rather take your chances with him doing exactly that, and he beat him on that play all the way to the end zone.
This will be fielded at the six. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. The Cowboys offense now, they head out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10. Kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use. Just something to get you off to a quick start.
They'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
Man open left side is Brown. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. 23 yards on the play. A good grab there by the former Central Michigan man, Antonio Brown.
And he ate up some real estate on the catch too, didn't he? I think the most impressive part of it, though, if there's a chance for him to get the football, even though he was covered well, he somehow finds a way to get it.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Vic now from the 50. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. Remember, quarterback's got to get rid of it. They don't have the tackle that they can fall back on anymore.
Here's Michael Vick. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Here's Brad Wing now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. This will be fielded at the 17. That'll be a net of only 30 here. 40-yard punt, 10 on the return. And that will come the offense as they take over. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage. Use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the two-minute warning.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now, I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. So it's our home team here in possession of the football as we come back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. So after the run by Jay Ajayi, here's first and 10. Now a handoff looking right. And he'll take it inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. And whistles, and we're going to have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left. This, in all probability, another run here on second and eight. Rodgers looking to throw. And that's complete to Adams. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Now they try the right side here. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down. Now Rodgers. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like an I-4 rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess. And now the third down throw incomplete as well.
That's a good job there creating the contact to force the incompletion. And now since it's fourth down, that should set up a field goal situation.
And a nice sigh of relief defensively to be able to hold them to three. So barring something extraordinary here in the closing stages, that field goal should just about put this one on ice.
Yeah, they've got to find two scores. So, you know, we're not going to exactly move it over there yet. It can be done, but boy, it's going to be a little bit of a stretch for them, isn't it?
Yeah, they would have to move incredibly quick and have some luck, too. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yep, two-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again. But they can't worry about the last 2 points. The only thing that matters is scoring quickly. Then they'll take it from there.
Now a play fake here on first down. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. That goes for a gain of 31. First down now, but that clock rolling. Now Michael Vick. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. A solid gain of 15 yards, and the sticks move. And with the clock ticking under 50 seconds now, he spikes it.
No.
Vic. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands. Guess what? Creates a lot of confusion. Kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you go make a play on the football.
Vic to throw it. Throw left side, complete to Ross. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Now here's a timeout coming on the defensive side of the ball. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages.
What? Tell something I don't know. What? Tell something I don't know. I don't think so, Mr. Vic. You're going to need some, of that Vic's vape cream once I'm done with it. Let's go.
Complete here, so a little razzle dazzle on that one, but they couldn't hook up, and it's third down.
He spiked the ball a little razzle dazzle. Oh, he couldn't do shit with it.
And this is caught at the end, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. As his guys are in for six, and the Cowboys draw a bit closer. Coming from where they were, they knew this was going to be tough, but they got the touchdown. Now they need the miracle, the onside kick, and a little extra.
Yeah, and you have to get the onside kick. You want to have the ball bounce around a lot and eat up time. You want to be able to grab it, possess it, and get your offense out there for what you just termed a miracle last chance.
And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a camper on this one. They had to go for it with no timeouts remaining, though, now. This one's as
good as I'm going to piss y'all off.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best, did everything they could to try and get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try it. It was their only option. And now
that is going to be grabbed and pulled down. And a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. Rodgers throwing here. On the move to his left. He's letting it fly for Cooks. This is caught inside the 15. And this results in 6. Touchdown. Brandon Cooks. 54 yards. And the Madden Legends will extend their lead. Perhaps a sigh of relief from the Madden Legends after that score.
Yeah, I think you're exactly right about that. I don't think they expected to be challenged today. But if you're part of the Madden...
It's the coach in Orlando, and you're tuned in to Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Coming up, we've got a good one on tap between the Madden Legends and the Denver Broncos. With that, we're off to the Rocky Mountain. Standing by in Denver, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Happy to be on hand. I'm Brandon Gunn with Charles Davis. And before we kick, partner, your keys to the game, please.
Well, my keys are on the defensive side of the ball for both teams. And the big one, making sure you avoid giving up the big play. These safeties are going to get tested all game long. Their job, keep the ball in front of them, tackle people, make them run extra plays in order to try and score.
Sighting
of Terrell Davis, the Broncos great with the ball in his hand in this game.
two-time Super Bowl champion and MVP of Super Bowl 32.
And also, of course, the Broncos' all-time leading rusher.
False start, offense.
And that'll be accepted, of course, and that brings him back five. A false start backs him up five, first and 15. They go play action here on first down. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course. Jalen Ramsey right there in coverage to knock it away.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
They lost four there, and it's third down. Now that play was doomed right from the start.
They just about ran into every defender on that one, didn't he? It felt like everyone got a piece of that tackle.
Third and long, it's Stafford. And this is going to be incomplete.
And third down is a key down in any game you play. And third down defense, something we've got to watch in this one. Got to be effective on the passing downs. That's a pretty good first step right there.
They'll look to set up his blockers. So a change of possession here on the punt. Back onto the field comes the offense for the Madden Legends. That opening drive ended with the INT. It didn't lead to points, but still not the way they were hoping to begin the game.
How about going and telling your defense, thank you, a huge thank you. You said didn't lead to points, start off that drive. Now they've got a chance to...
And nothing but daylight ahead. And he will score. It's a touchdown. Devontae Adams, 67 yards. And the Madden Legends have taken the early lead. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions, and I'd hear nine from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the nine, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
This will be fielded at the 8. Denver getting set to take the field. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, do you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. Don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. 2nd and 3. They'll fake it. Now Stafford. He's going to launch this thing way down. He's got a man. Complete. A gain of 32 that time. Back alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. It's Bronco football to begin quarter number 2. And they've got it here with a first down. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for 1st and 10. The first down carry for Davis. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39.
Anytime you call an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case. That play got bottled up.
They'll run it here. This is James White. And again, the run defense stout this time. He maybe gets back to the line of scrimmage, but no more.
Early down stuffs have put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this day, has got to be priority one.
Now Stafford. They will find his man for the first time, Demaryius Thomas. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th.
That was a nice catch, and if the goal was to get into field goal range, it certainly appears that they accomplished that.
Well, and sometimes that's what you dial up in these situations, right, when you want 3?
Well, if the goal was to get into field goal territory, even though it'll be a long attempt, I think they accomplished that.
And sometimes you have plays for that. It's not always a first down when you want three, get a little bit closer, make it an easier shot.
Yeah, sometimes you just have to concede to the defense, and they know what you're trying to get done, and to try and get any more than that is almost folly. Take what you can get, maybe have an opportunity to put 3 points on the board.
Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. And highlights and analysis of this first half. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third.
How about this offense already feeling good about themselves with a touchdown already in their first drive? They certainly come out firing, even though that one was incomplete.
With the 7-0 lead, more apt to take a shot like that downfield.
Hey, you're one to the good. Go ahead and try and crush your advantage.
And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
That's quite a spot there for his first carry of the game, but obviously they had plenty of faith in him, didn't they?
No question about it. And here, why not go with the fresh legs? Able to push forward, pick up that first. Rodgers now on first down. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. Give him 30 yards there.
That's a big-time pitch and catch right there. Partner, I remember the days when quarterbacks would try this. They were holding their breath, but nowadays, they're counting on their receiver to be just a little bit better than the defensive back when it's one-on-one and the ball's in the air like that.
And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
And complete to Zach Ertz. A very solid gain of 27.
But when you hit him on the move like that, he's able to get into open field with a full head of steam. Oh, boy, it's going to be tough to get him down.
Yeah, there was a big window. They're lucky they did get him down. Throwing is Rodgers. Escaping, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Von Miller, he's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. On play action, Rodgers. And put it on the board, it's 6, a touchdown. Antonio Brown from 17 yards out, and the Madden Legends will extend their lead. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Now the Broncos offense, they get set to head back onto the field. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game. And typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. There you have it. Halftime quickly over. Third quarter, here we go. So we have come to halftime in what's already a 2-touchdown game. This is Field at the goal line. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Here comes the Broncos offensive unit here as they'll have it first to begin this
What's up, Digi?
Quarter. They come out here with a 0 on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think just they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they felt they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out. Yeah, he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair.
If these guys are going to chop into that deficit, they got to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage will be found.
From the gun on third down, Stanford. Another drive comes and goes, still nothing on the scoreboard.
Yeah, and when the second half comes, you know, it's real easy to get discouraged and wonder if you're ever going to get things started. You just got to fight through it. Got to keep pounding away.
That's pulled in at the 32. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive. As they score here, especially a touchdown, it's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, is that you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, the cheater right there on the brink on it then.
Flush to his right. And some room to work. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down. Throwing on first down is Rodgers. Looking deep for his tight end, Ertz. Trying for the tight end, Ertz, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Justin Simmons. And a very good return as he takes us all the way up to the 35-yard line.
Ah, Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball, and I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
After the interception, here's Stanford. Got a man right side. It's Sharp. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
And, partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion. But he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. Off of play action. Here's Stafford. Blitz coming and down he goes. Jake Ryan coming hard on the blitz. He dumps him for a loss of 8. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see.
Welcome back now to Denver. It's the Broncos trailing, but they do have possession of the football as we begin quarter number 4. Here's Stafford now on second down. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Casey Hayward, and this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games, and now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you have to claw your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
They lost 2 there, and it's third down. Throwing is Rodgers on third down. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And that one incomplete. Had some position, but couldn't hold on, and it brings up fourth down. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play, and the officials are instructed. If there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. The Broncos offense now gets
I don't care what happens. All out blitz.
They'll start on the ground. It's Terrell Davis. Oh, and this is going to wind up a safety. Well, there is still time to recover from this. It remains a two-score game even with the 2 points there, but let's just say things not trending in the right direction.
I like that phrase. I'm going to say it along with you. Things are definitely not trending in the right direction. They needed something on that drive. Instead, they gave up 2 points and a lot of hope.
Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. There's a handoff to Ajayi to begin the drive. And unable to get downhill there, so he'll take this up to about the 37. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. Have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up second and 7. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Ajayi. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. And now the Broncos will burn another timeout here as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's got some space here. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Now a handoff looking right. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. That one looks like he'll throw here. Oh, did he hang on to it? He did on the dive. Nice grab. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
Well, partner, when you ask anyone other than your QB to throw the ball, you must have a lot of confidence or you think you're really going to fake them out. And it looks like they did exactly that.
Yeah, going deep in the playbook and a great grab on the other end. But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. And that one goes incomplete. They tried something out of the bag of tricks, but it's incomplete and now second down. And they'll go on the ground. Trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. J.J. Watt, the one that gets him down. I guess the simple question, why not just take a knee there?
I don't understand either why you would take any sort of a chance. We've seen it happen in the game of football.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Zach Brown with a big-time sack on third down. And it'll be a loss of 7.
Brandon, that's just football 101. If you're out of the pocket, you've got to get rid of the football in this situation. You cannot take a sack in a 2-minute drill.
So the Broncos coming out now. They have a little bit of time left here, but this one not going to go their way.
And this is where, in this situation for me, you just go ahead and run out the clock, shake hands, congratulations, and move on. Because now, you're not going to make up for what's happened during the game in this last sequence.
We'll see what they do here in this last sequence. And he gets this one just shy of the 35 to the 34. He got 29 yards that time. And he'll get up and spike it with 11 seconds remaining. And that one goes incomplete. They tried something out of the bag of tricks, but it's incomplete and now second down. And now whistles here and a flag down. Looked like someone got going a little early.
False start, offense.
And that'll set them back 5. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. He's going to let it fly. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Here's Stanford. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Trevor Williams with a pick. And his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line. And now we'll get a timeout here. They're able to stop it with 1 second to go in this game. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10. Rodgers looking to throw. He'll be brought down by the Broncos. It's a sack.
It's time to punch one of two tickets to the Super Bowl.
Seems like we were just starting training camp, but here we are in October, and off we go on EA Sports. Here's the dangerous Tyreek Hill. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
And he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one. And that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. These guys hooking up right away here, Charles. Two plays, both passes in his direction, and both catches.
And in our time together, have we not seen the tight end position continue to develop in the passing game? You know, at some point, we may not call them tight ends anymore. We may have to come up with an entirely different way of designating that position and what they do on the field. Because when I hear tight end, I think of the old school, hand in the dirt, blocking on the line of scrimmage. These guys are much more receiver than they are guys who are going to move in the pass in the running game.
A first carry for the Hall of Famer, Barry Sanders. And he's going to be met at about the 43. Brian Urlacher, the big middle linebacker, in on the stop.
When you think about big-time middle linebackers, you do think about the strength and the force that they play with, as we just saw there from Brian Urlacher. But what an athlete. Remember, he was a safety in college at the University of New Mexico.
And the NFL Defensive Player of the Year back in 05. Also, Bears all-time leading tackler, almost 1,800 of them. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it, because now everyone gets locked in. The confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
It's a gain of 5. So forget the throwing it out. The penalty makes this 1st and 10. They'll run the option right here on 1st down. And maybe the wrong read there, as he's going to go down immediately. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be 2nd down.
I don't think there's any doubt that if it's me, I'd be really cautious about continuing to call this play, because you got to know, defenders, if they get a free shot at the QB, they want to take it, and they want to take it big.
And they got it there on the option play for a loss. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
I'm not sure what this play was designed for him specifically, but they got through the progressions and got the ball to him. So, 2nd catch on the drive. He may not be a primary guy, but they definitely want him involved, don't they?
Yeah, absolutely. This early, the opening drive, as you said, 2 catches. So, if they can get him going in the passing game, it should open up his running game, too. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. Working out of the gun, Michael Vick. And he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. 6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves him with a 1st and goal.
I know some people express surprise when Barry Sanders catches the football, because his rushing numbers get most of the attention, but he also contributed his career in the passing game, like we just saw there.
Yeah, he had nearly 3,000 career receiving yards, and I think that gets overshadowed by the over 15,000 rushing yards that Mr. Sanders had. Only 1 yard on the completion, it's 2nd and goal. And so far, a very nice, methodical opening drive.
This has the feel of a scripted drive that they rehearsed perfectly all week long, and now they're executing it on game day.
Script looks good so far, and he is out of bounds here. That time, the completion goes for 4 yards, and we're set up with a 3rd and goal. driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, but now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this four down territory? Might you go for it?
We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll take you to Orlando and Jonathan Coachman. Coach will have highlights and analysis of this first half, one that's featured no touchdowns as of yet on either side.
So his job's a little bit easier for this halftime.
Need to give the coach some highlights here.
Yes, we do.
And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And Prater's kick is on the money. It's good. And the Titans hit the scoreboard first. It's 3-0. So they get three, certainly hoping for six after a 13-play drive.
So you console yourself on defense by saying you did your job, right? If they go 13 plays, you only give up a field goal. You did a nice job there. But here's the other part. 13 plays, you don't force any mistakes. You don't take the ball away. Maybe that's the way they should look at it.
And that'll make it second down. Rodgers in control as he hurries his guys to the line. On second down, here's Rodgers. Flushed out right. And this one's incomplete. Devontae Adams, the intended receiver. And it's third down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum. Big play right in his hands. Unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense if that fell harmlessly to the ground. Rodgers gonna throw. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down. First down now, but that clock rolling. On first and 10, here's Rodgers. Going deep for Benjamin. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
Eluding the pressure right. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. The improv act there, good for 9, and now they'll be looking at a 3rd and 1. Now Rodgers, a free play. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sack back at the 46.
Offside. Defense.
Well, we looked at each other right when he flinched. We knew that flag was coming.
Yeah, offside's easy call. Mark off the 5 and keep it moving.
On first down, Rodgers. Hurts over the middle. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles.
Your
and
style of play.
As the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number 2. Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch. Good for 8 yards. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And his throw is going to be incomplete. They were looking to get it to Kelvin Benjamin there. And it's 3rd and short.
He's a little trigger happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. Rodgers looking to throw on 3rd and 2. And that is incomplete.
So it looked like they were getting ready to convert there on 3rd down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a 4th down decision.
They'll go for it. It's Rodgers. And my goodness, this is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And as a result, it'll be Titan football on the turnover on downs. And he'll have a tough time living that one down. It's one thing, Charles, to drop a pass. It's quite another to drop it on 4th down.
And so many teams work on that in terms of locking in on those key downs. You know, I've seen, you know, you and I have both been to practices where we've seen
Hey, third down situation. Big third down alert. What did you?
Fourth down play. Make sure you focus just a little bit extra. It didn't pay off in that situation.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six.
These
offenses seemingly still back at the hotel for the first half. 3-0 our score as the second half gets underway. This is fielded at the goal line. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line.
Meow.
Out now come the legends.
Meow.
It's a close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here at half two.
I would agree with that totally.
Holy shit, they got a 90 over. Okay.
We just saw another example.
Get away from. Oh my god. Where did you come from?
Now you know what?
Fuck you!
Deep right side. That's gonna be knocked
down.
This defense.
Why, bro?
Every deep ball that is thrown downfield, and look, it doesn't matter whether you play man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man.
Don't you fair catch it, bitch! Yeah! I'm gonna knock y'all up!
So possession goes over here on the punt. And it'll be Titan football. The Titans offense gears up for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the ball back here. Didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Now how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points. And turning that the ball back over. They want to do their part now.
I ain't losing this shit, man.
Oh, let's score some points and to get a little more cushion. We've become so accustomed to it, you sort of take it for granted.
You really do, but he is so good that every team in his division, every year, is trying to
We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. The Madden Legends offense trotting out again. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They got to just take a deep breath, relax.
Man, motherfucker got Waddy. Wait, no, he don't have what?
Call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play.
And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. 7 yards there. Good.
What you betching, Digit?
Sides of blitzing during a rundown because sometimes you get out of your gap.
Digit.
Fit the run quite as well. Now ready.
And he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping is the bait and move laterally. Open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Can he hit me? Can
he
hit
me?
Can
he
hit
me? 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third. Meow! They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. He needed three. He got two. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here.
Digit.
Fourth of the yard.
Better cut that shit out.
Maybe seriously have to think about going for it. One score down, here we go.
Oh, bullshit, I got that. I'm challenging that. Why can't I? They said there's nothing to challenge. Bullshit, there ain't nothing to challenge. Fuck this, man. Oh, Blitz, kill this goddamn sucker. Fuck you.
Can you hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Can you hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take. It's a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ball game. Here's Thomas Morstead now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he'll go ahead and field this at the 5. A very good return there. Give him an even 20 yards.
All right. Nothing but small plays. Let's go.
The Madden legends heading back onto the field. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on 4, turned it over in their own territory. But the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it. Not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
but
he up.
He trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much. And I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it. Be aggressive because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own side.
Now we'll see what his offense can do. A good decision in the end. The pull and run gets him 9 yards at a first.
All right, partner, I'm a defender, but I've got to express my admiration there. Moving around, making it happen, and instead of worrying about protecting himself, he goes and gets the first down. I've got to give it to him on that one.
Normally, you don't want your guy taking shots, your quarterback, but it's winning time here in the fourth quarter. If he needs to make those plays with the legs, go ahead, right?
Yeah, no doubt about
Digit.
It.
Digit,
at this stage of the
get
game,
over here.
All protections, they're off.
Shut up.
He's back to throw. Can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Jurrell Casey in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. Back to throw. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. As they get right at the 30-second mark of this fourth quarter.
Rodgers what are you catching for?
5 straight completions here in this second half. 1st and 10. Back to throw. This is caught. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. He got 29 yards that time. He'll look to throw. Touchdown. Zach Ertz from 3 yards out. And the Madden legends draw a bit closer.
Offside. Defense.
And yes, they want the points, so they will decline the penalty. No question there.
You don't think they spent a couple seconds mulling over with the penalty?
I don't even know why they asked the sideline.
Not at all. When you put the ball in the end zone on a takeaway, take the points and keep moving.
Santos with the extra point, and it would appear, barring some late heroics, they're going to get out of here with a come-from-behind victory. Tyreek Hill set to return it. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 20.
Can you hear me, hear me, hear me, hear me, hear me? Can you hear me, 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 h
One last shot for Michael Vick. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty. And with that, the ball game is over.
Baby, man, my secondary just got a hell of a lot of OP. Right there, where the fuck is he, my like speed bag all the time? Fuck that, I'm getting him in the game, man. Are you better? Oh my god, you're better. Damn, I thought it would hopefully. And Boykins. Digit, that's not even a person, you idiot. Meow. Put in the bed, bubbling in bed, bubbling.